Hey guys, my name's Ron White. I'm a two-time USA memory champion. I have a memory course at blackbeltmemory.com where I teach people how to memorize stuff. And recently, a medical student was going through my black belt memory course. And he said, Ron, how do I memorize this diagram of the heart? But not only do I need to memorize the diagram of the heart, I need to memorize the pattern, the way that the blood flows in the way around the heart, the order. Now, there's several different ways you can do this. There's no right way or wrong way, as long as it works for you. I'm going to show you one way to do this though, and I'm also going to teach you the Mind Palace method if you don't know it. Here's the Mind Palace method. Imagine you're standing in the doorway of the room that you're in right now. You look to your immediate left. What's the first big piece of furniture? Is it a desk, a bed, a TV, whatever? Doesn't matter. That would be number one. Then go around the room clockwise, always in a clockwise or counterclockwise way. Going around the room, let's say clockwise, number the next piece of furniture. That would be two. One, two. Keep going. Three, four, five. Pick big items, not small items. And then you would go to the next room and you would number, start in the doorway, and you would number 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Then you would go to the next room, start in the doorway, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. You have two options right now. You can pause the video now and number 15 pieces of furniture, or you can just try to do this on the fly with me. If I'm going too fast, don't be afraid to use the pause button. And this might not make sense. As we're going through this, you might be like, what in the world is he doing? I want to memorize a map of the heart. Stick with me. Stick with me to the end, and I promise you, you'll have it memorized, even if during in the middle of it, you're like, where's he going with this? It will all come together. So, I'm gonna make the screen go pretty much blank because I don't want you focusing on me and I don't want you focusing on the map of the heart. I want you to have these pictures in your brain. In this room, we're gonna do five words. In the next room, we're gonna do five words. And in the third room, we're gonna do five words. If you think you will be able to follow along as I give them to you, then by all means, keep watching the video. Most of you, however, will benefit though by pausing the video now, getting out a sheet of paper and writing out the 15 pieces of furniture and trying to get them in your head. Also, in this video, you might think you're going crazy and hearing a bird in the background. Well, you're not going crazy. It's my bird, Hugin, and he chirped a lot in the background. So listen for him and pay attention. More importantly, don't let it distract you. I want you to look to the, in your mind, or in reality, I want you to look at that number one piece of furniture. So in the room that you're in right now, look at the number one piece of furniture. And on that piece of furniture, I want you to imagine a cave. There is a cave and veins are growing out of this cave. Like a huge cave going down a tunnel into the crown. A cave with veins coming out of it. Go to the second piece of furniture. The number two piece of furniture, and I want you to imagine a tree on that piece of furniture. See a tree growing out of that number two piece of furniture. Look over there, imagine you got a chainsaw and you're chopping down that tree. Now go back to one and review the cave with veins growing out of the cave. Go back to number two and review a tree. On number three, I want you to imagine your cousin, and your cousin is on this piece of furniture, and your cousin's riding around on a tricycle, and your cousin turns off a valve. So your cousin on a tricycle, and they turn off a valve. Moving across to the next number four piece of furniture, I want you to imagine a vent, like a vent, and it's blowing out air. Just look over there at that piece of furniture, and there's a vent, and phew, air is shooting out of that piece of furniture. Air is shooting out of that piece of furniture on a vent. Go to piece of furniture number five now. On piece of furniture number five, I want you to imagine some lungs, and these lungs are breathing. And you go over there and you turn a valve and it turns the lungs off. Lungs breathing, you turn off a valve and it turns the lungs off. Now let's go back and review the five in this room. You have a cave with veins growing out of it. On number two, you have a tree. On number three, you have a tricycle and your cousin's riding it. Your cousin turns off a valve as he's riding the tricycle. Number four, you have a vent and lots of air is blowing out of that vent. Number five, you have some lungs breathing and you shut them off with a valve. Now let's go to the next room. in the next room now, number six. On number six, I want you to see the Mona Lisa, the painting, the Mona Lisa. And imagine she's breathing, she's taking deep breaths. The Mona Lisa breathing on number six. Go to number seven now. In your mind, I want you to see on number seven a pair of lungs. Go back and review number six, the Mona Lisa. Review seven, the pair of lungs. Number eight, I want you to imagine a pair of lungs and veins are coming out of these lungs. Two lungs, a pair, and veins are coming out of those lungs. Number seven, it's just a pair of lungs. Go back and review number six. It is the Mona Lisa, and she's breathing. Go back and review number five. It's a pair of lungs, and you shut them off with a valve. Four, it's a vent that's blowing out air. Go back and review three. It's your cousin riding a tricycle, and your cousin turns off the valve. Go back and review number two. It's a tree. Go back and review number one. A cave with veins coming out of it. Now let's go all the way back through and we'll stop at number nine because that's the next one. On number nine, I want you to see a tree growing out of that piece of furniture. Look over there at that number nine piece of furniture. There's a tree growing out of number nine. Number 10, I want you to see your cousin riding a bicycle. On number three, he was riding a tricycle. And you can remember that because it was a third piece of furniture and he was riding a tricycle. On number 10, he's riding a bicycle. So three was a tricycle, your cousin riding a bicycle. Now you've memorized 10 words. Let's go back and review them. On the first one, a cave with veins going out of it. Number two, a tree. Number three, your cousin riding a tricycle and he turns off a valve. Number four, a vent. Number five, lungs, and you're turning them off with a valve. Number six, the Mona Lisa breathing. Number seven, a pair of lungs. Number eight, lungs and veins are coming out of them. Number nine, a tree. Number 10, a bicycle and your cousin on a bicycle. Number 11, I want you to see a vent on number 11, and it's just blowing out air. It feels so good. If there's five in a room, you're in your third room now. If there's five in a room, you're in your third room. You are on your 11th piece of furniture. Vent blowing out air on number 11. Number 12, let's move one piece of furniture over. What's the next piece of furniture in that room? I want you to see a valve and you hit it with an oar, like an oar on a boat, a valve, and you hit it with an oar on a boat. Go back and review 11. A vent. Vent is shooting out of that piece of furniture. Number 12, there is a valve and you hit it with an oar, like an oar to a boat. Number 13, I want you to imagine just an oar. Maybe you see a boat there and there's two oars and you're paddling. An oar is the only word you're remembering here. Number 14, I want you to imagine art, like the Mona Lisa on number 14. Look at that piece of furniture and see the Mona Lisa. The Mona Lisa on that piece of furniture. Number 15, I want you to imagine it's covered in caterpillars. It's covered in caterpillars on number 15. That's the last one in that room, if you've done five in a room. Caterpillars all over that piece of furniture. And then if you want to remember one last word, just remember the word veins. And you could imagine veins on the next piece of furniture, wherever that is. So guys, here's the deal. I just gave you 15 words and you imagined them on 15 or 16 pieces of furniture around your house. So now guys, let's go back and let's think about the words I gave you. And we memorized veins in a cave for superior and inferior vena cava. I didn't bother to memorize the word superior or inferior, just vena and cava. And I did that with veins in a cave. The next word was a tree. This is for the word atrium. Now it is the right atrium, but there's a little trick here. We deal with the right side of the heart before the blood gets to the lungs. Once the blood gets to the lungs, then it's dealing with the left side of the heart. So I don't feel like we need to memorize right atrium. We just need to memorize atrium. The number three, tricuspid valve. Your cousin, cuspid, tricycle, and valve, he's turning off a valve. Tricuspid valve. Number four, ventricle. We had a vent. Now, again, we don't have to memorize right. We know it's the right because it hasn't been to the lungs yet. Number five, we have lungs and a valve. Pulmonary for lungs, valve, valve. Pulmonary valve. Now this is actually the pulmonary semilunar valve. If you don't think you remember the word semilunar, then imagine a moon in there in this picture as well. Add that to the picture. Number six, we had the Mona Lisa. That is our picture for the word arteries. Arteries. And pulmonary, she's breathing, right? Pulmonary arteries. Number seven, we just had a pair of lungs. That is just remembered lungs. Number eight, we had lungs with veins coming out of them. Lungs are going to represent pulmonary, and then veins, veins. So pulmonary veins. Now this is the right pulmonary veins and the left pulmonary veins. I don't think you need to memorize right the words right and left. I think your brain should just fill that in. On the next piece of furniture, we had a tree. That is for atrium. And remember, since it's after the lungs, it's going to be the left. So it's the left atrium. On the next piece of furniture, we had our cousin, and he was riding a bicycle, the bicuspid valve. Number 11, on this one we had a vent for ventricle, and remember, since it's after the lungs, it's the left ventricle. On the next piece of furniture, we had an oar for aorta and a valve. It was hitting a valve. This is your aortic valve. Now the word semilunar is in there as well. If you need to add a picture of a moon to remember lunar, semilunar, then do that. But for me, aortic, I would automatically know semilunar valve. Number 13, you had an oar. That was for aorta. Number 14, you had artwork for arteries. 15, you had a caterpillar for capillaries. I thought capillaries and caterpillar kind of sounded similar. And then number 16, veins. 16 words in the correct order as they flow around the heart. How do you memorize them on this diagram? Honestly, I think if you look at that diagram, you can kind of draw like a squiggly line and memorize the pattern of that squiggly line. And then if you have the words memorized on your mind palace, you should just be able to go in there and label that squiggly line. And that's how I would do it. I would approach this by memorizing it with the mind palace, memorizing a list of 16 words. Then I would memorize a squiggly line, and I would just go back and label that squiggly line using the mind palace to help me out. So if you liked this video, I do have a full course on this called Black Belt Memory. You can get it at the link down below. And please give me some feedback. Let me know what you thought. But memorize 15 or 16 pieces of furniture. And now here, guys, here's the beauty of this system. You know, I took a significant portion of this video and explained to you what the Mind Palace is. Well, you can use this for other things. Now, you might want to use different pieces of furniture for different parts of the body or whatever, but you get the idea here. Hopefully you do. So guys, this is an introduction to the Mind Palace. If you would like a full course on the Mind Palace, click the link down below and you get my full Black Belt Memory course. But practice this. You should be able to memorize the blood flow to the heart. I'll see you on the next lesson.